On September 12th, while delivering a speech at this year's Air and Space Forces Association's major conference outside of Washington, D.C., the upcoming chairman of the Joint Chiefs unveiled two fresh pictures of the B-21 Raider. While the initial images of the B-21 were revealed in December, depicting the aircraft from the front, these shots were taken in a highly controlled setting, and no images showcasing different angles were available until this moment. Apart from these, Northrop Grumman has also published an image. The B-21 Raider is set to become the cornerstone of the bomber fleet, gradually taking over from the B-1B Lancer and B-2 Spirit. This cutting-edge bomber will offer both survivability and long-range deep strike capabilities, serving as a deterrent against aggression and ensuring the protection of the United States, its allies, and its partners. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the B-21 Raider based on the latest images. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The images provide some intriguing details. 1. The B-21 is already marked with its serial number 0001 and bears the insignia of Edwards Air Force Base, ED, in preparation for its upcoming flight test program set to be conducted there. 2. The first-ever B-21 aircraft is equipped with a large air data probe positioned at an angle on the lower front section of the aircraft's left side. This will be essential for collecting crucial air data during the B-21's maiden flight and subsequent primary flight dynamics test missions. 3. The cockpit appears to be very small, significantly more confined than that of the B-2 bomber. The side windows on the B-21 have a distinct compact design with a unique angle. The overall visibility from the Raider seems to be quite limited. 4. The B-21's air inlets and power plant enclosures are seamlessly integrated with the rest of its airframe. The blending of B-21's engine intakes and nacelle areas seem very well done, showing just a little bulge. This serves as a valuable pointer of the B-21 Raider's strategy for concealing its engine inlets from enemy radar systems, particularly those operating from lower angles. Given the B-21's expected high operational altitude, most radar-equipped enemy aircraft are unlikely to be positioned above it. The exact number of engines on the B-21, whether it has 2 or 4, remains undisclosed. 5. A decent view of the B-21's flight control surfaces are also available. It features 3 flaperons on the outboard side of the wing and 1 on the inboard side. This design differs from the B-2, which has a more complex sawtooth trailing edge platform with 2 flaperons inboard and outboard, as well as a variable geometry beaver tail in the center of its trailing edge. The B-21 opts for a simpler W trailing edge, resembling the initial design of the B-2 before its low-altitude penetration mission requirements were added. 6. The B-21's gear doors are notable for their design. Unlike the B-2, which had large trapezoidal main gear doors, the B-21 features 6-sided doors that enclose its single truck main landing gear. In contrast, the larger and heavier B-2 utilized a double truck landing gear arrangement. 7. B-21 appears to have a serrated indentation on the upper part of the airframe, located behind the cockpit. This feature likely plays a role in the air refueling receptacle system, a placement similar to that on the B-2. 8. The ejection hatch panels can be seen with dotted lines on the top of the aircraft. 9. Several air data sensors are present. There appear to be a dozen on the lower fuselage, as well as two strips in front of the cockpit, similar to what we see on the B-2. 10. Two trapezoidal apertures can be observed, each flanking the lower nose section of the B-21, and seemingly designed to accommodate a sensor each. This could be the Northrop Grumman's electronically scanned, multifunction, reconfigurable, integrated sensor, EMRIS, which has seamless data communication, sensor, and electronic warfare capabilities. B-21 is being developed under the Long Range Strike Bomber (LRSB) program. A request for proposal to develop the aircraft was issued in July 2014. On the 27th of October 2015, the U.S. Department of Defense awarded the development contract to Northrop Grumman. The B-21 designation, according to the U.S. Air Force, was chosen because the aircraft is the first new bomber of the 21st century, while the name Raider was chosen to represent the Doolittle Raiders, who flew a surprise attack during World War II. The U.S. Air Force plans to purchase 80 to 100 LRSB aircraft. Back in June of 2021, it was revealed that the B-21's inaugural flight, initially planned for later that year, faced delays, ultimately pushing the milestone into 2022. However, several challenges extended this timeline further to 2023, and now there's a growing likelihood that the first flight might occur in 2024. Secretary of the Air Force Frank Kendall stated at a media roundtable on the sidelines of the Air and Space Forces conference on September 11th regarding the aircraft's possible first flight, "We're still hopeful on having first flight this year. If I were to say it will, I would be making a very specific prediction, and I'd never do that about an acquisition program for something that hasn't happened yet. Okay? We're going through a number of things to get ready for first flight. There's always risk involved. Something can surprise you. So absent any unexpected surprises, and surprises with acquisition programs." It's evident that the first sixth generational bomber is getting ever closer to being operational.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.